So it is an exciting time. We have two new federal funding streams for early childhood, which is terrific. We got an historic increase in the Child Care and Development Block Grant, CCDBG, $2.4 billion, which is really exciting for us because sometimes we don't get as much money, though I also would be clear and say it is a down payment of what we really need. So why would I say that? One in six kids that's eligible gets really good child care. So we've got a long way to go. And there's a really important state role to play. So even though there's federal money, we want to make sure that the states are really using it well. So it came down in the form of a block grant. There's all kinds of flexibility. So if governors and their staffs and legislators really do a wonderful job, then what we'll have is more kids having access to quality childcare. On the PDG side, we had preschool development grants before. This is kind of flavor number two. They're not generated out of Department of Ed this time. They're coming out of the Department of Human Services. I think in some ways, what we're looking at is an opportunity to not only advance quality pre-K, but really systemically looking at quality early experiences and early learning experiences for kids. Again, wonderful to have the federal funding that'll come down to the states, but a really important state play so that we can make sure those dollars really go to advance quality and access both. Probably one of the most important things that states can do is tell the stories. So if we're going to keep those dollars and hopefully even increase those dollars, then we need success stories. What's working? Where's it working? What's happening? And if it's not working, why? If you've been around a long enough time, what you know is that sometimes early childhood gets really siloed. So people will look at part of what kids need, but not holistically at what kids need. So it's great to do early learning, but that isn't going to solve everything in the life of a really disadvantaged young kiddo. So I see a wonderful movement that looks at a whole kid and what we really need. So at the Alliance for Early Success, we looked at the science. And when you ask simply, what does the science say a young child needs to be successful? They need to be born healthy and they need to stay healthy. They need strong families that can support them. And they need quality early learning experiences. So by definition, you can't kind of pick off one thing. So I see a movement where we really are looking at all of those things together. And now that we're at an NGA governor's meeting, the governor is in an amazing catbird seat. So there is no one else that has total control of anything like a governor over early childhood. And they also, by being heads of state, can look across departments. So that's that holistic view. And little kid stuff happens everywhere. It happens in the Department of Ed. It happens in Departments of Human Services. It happens in Departments of Health. But we also kind of can think creatively, and that's a movement. So, you know, lots of families have to travel to find childcare or preschool or pre-K programs. So you could look at Departments of Transportation and what's happening there. If we're talking strong families, we want them to be in safe, affordable houses. And we want them to be in communities that are safe, where kids can play and have access to resources that my kids have. So you'd look at parks and rec and community development. So I see that trend and I'm really excited by it. There is tremendous energy around the workforce. But here's one of the things I worry about. A lot of times people talk about it, and they say, wow, it's really important to have a highly qualified workforce, but you kind of get that bobblehead doll thing. So yeah, it's really important. Or if you say, do you support it? Absolutely, I support it. But the resources and the policies around things like how to build a professional workforce, what are the professional development policies and opportunities, where's the funding for that, don't necessarily follow suit. So I do think there's renewed energy around a workforce. So think about this. If you were in an industry outside of our field, nobody, I think, would hold a business open or have an industry where you had a workforce that was not trained, that didn't have the education that they needed, that flat out wasn't competent. And if you didn't pay them and they continued to leave the minute you put money into whatever training you did, you'd probably sink. But in early childhood, those things happen. And we would miraculously expect that young kids are going to continue to succeed with a workforce that is educating them like that. So I think the movement is people know it now. It's not okay. So in my world, funders are coming together. I'd call out two projects. So one is called Power to the Profession. And the idea is, what are the competencies that the early childhood workforce needs so that our kids are truly getting quality early learning experiences and benefiting. Another is the ECWIN project, and that's Early Childhood Workforce Investment Initiative. Again, kind of a consensus where funders come together, pool money, pool ideas, work towards a common goal. So when those kinds of things happen, I think we'll make more progress than we've made before.